Let's discuss breakdown mechanism of a PN junction diode in reverse biasing. We have discussed at the time of characteristics of a PN junction diode that in reverse biasing, a constant current flows which is called reverse saturation current. You can recall in the curve VI characteristic, this reverse saturation current was denoted by the symbol I0, and it is due to minority carriers of the semiconductor, because we know that in reverse biasing, majority carriers are pulled away from the depletion layer and no current flows. So only due to some minority carriers present in p-type and n-type semiconductors, some current flows, which is of the order of microampere, that is called reverse saturation current, and it almost remains constant in reverse biasing. We also discussed when V increases, at a particular value which was denoted by VZ, covalent bonds near the junction start breaking, which is due to high electric field in the depletion layer. As we have discussed that in reverse biasing, external electric field supports the internal electric field and overall electric field increases, and at a specific value Vz or beyond this, the electric field becomes so high that covalent bonds near the junction start breaking. And we can write that suddenly large number of electron hole pairs are generated, and this suddenly increases the current in the circuit. This phenomena, we can write that this phenomena is called breakdown of PN junction, and this VZ, the voltage at which this breakdown takes place, is called breakdown voltage, or sometimes it is also termed as Zener voltage. When we talk about the phenomena of breakdown, which is breaking of covalent bond near the junction due to high electric field, this phenomena can be explained in two ways. We talk about breakdown mechanism. Breakdown mechanism is explained in two ways, under which we can explain how suddenly lot of electron hole pairs are generated and which increases the current in circuit. These phenomena are called, the very first one as Zener breakdown, and the second one is avalanche breakdown. In coming sections, we are going to discuss both of these breakdown phenomena in detail, which take place in different situations. Like Zener breakdown takes place when p-type and n-type semiconductors are heavily doped and the depletion layer is thin, and avalanche breakdown takes place when junction is relatively broader or depletion layer width is large and the semiconductors are moderately doped. Let's discuss both of these in detail in the coming sections.